get it. I understand, again, the need to make a statement. I just don't think that's the way to do it, particularly at this point. You know, I think the protests, the marches, and the coverage that this thing got was attention enough to make the statement and make people wake up and take a look at what's going on, as if people don't already know. I mean, we all know what the situation is, but I think maybe we took it a step too far. And again, it's just that I don't think that a lot of the people who may have been driving that particular part of the quote unquote protest, I question their motives. You know, we might have been talking about 20% protests and 80% just feeling like acting a fool and causing some trouble and, you know, standoffs with the police and all that kind of stuff, man. You know, that's just, what can you say? That's the future. So, again, let me know what you think about that. Get at me, Vic, at BigVicPresents.com. That's Vic with a K. And other than that, you know, we're moving into, again, it's March. The Olympics wrapped up. Really, really just heart-wrenching story in the Olympics with the hockey. And I talked a little bit about this last time. I didn't have a whole lot of interest in what was going on with the Olympics, but one of the things to watch was the American hockey team put together a real nice team, man. And I'm not a big hockey guy, you know, but you know, you can't deny a good game, and the intensity and the excitement surrounding it. It went into, you know, into sudden death, and I mean, it just doesn't get any better than that. Unless the Americans came home with the gold. Unfortunately, they stopped just this short. They got stopped just that much short. The Canadian team, who was really favored to kind of win this thing, take the gold all along, and who was kind of a little shaky there at some points in the beginning of the tournament, but really righted the ship and got it together. Props to them for pulling it together and hanging in there, because the Americans really, really were not going away. And just showed a lot of guts and a lot of heart, and just couldn't quite finish it off. So, you know, very, very proud of the American team. Good job, fellas. Props go to the Canadian team for winning the gold and doing what you guys set out to do, because I know you expected to win the gold. Probably got a little bit surprised. It's a little harder than you might have imagined it was going to be. And you know, no thanks to those feisty Americans. Way to pull it together, fellas, and fight for it. Congratulations on the silver. Maybe next time it'll be the gold. But good job on that. And with that, we're rolling into March Madness on the way. A couple more weeks, actually about 2-3 more weeks away, we get into March Madness, man, and it's going to be a beautiful thing. You know, the tournament, the NCAA tournament, is always one of the bigger events and just a lot of fun. I think as is the case with a lot of college sports, sometimes a little more fun than the professional sports, because these kids are just playing for the love of it. You know, some of them are playing, of course, with aspirations for professional careers, but a lot of these kids know they're not going to be pros. So this is it for them. This is, you know, making the tournament and trying to get as deep into it as they can get, and maybe pull off a championship. It's stories that they'll be telling their loved ones for years. And, you know, that's something that's a big deal and very special. So that makes for some exciting matchups. And, you know, get in and let me know what your picks are. I haven't really gotten as deep into it yet as I want to get into it to start seeing who the good teams are and, you know, who I'm expecting to come all the way through. But it's never too early to get at me and let me know. Vic at BigVicPresents.com. That's Vic with a K. And on the professional front, you know, Cleveland made a move, got Anton Jameson, used to be a Golden State Warrior, for those of you who remember those days, but they pulled him away from the Washington Wizards, which is probably a good thing for him. I always kind of liked Anton, although there was always something about him that I just felt like something slightly missing in his game. Not necessarily his game so much, but maybe personality-wise, maybe not quite as intense as I like to see a cat. And but I think he'll be a good addition to the Cleveland Cavaliers as they make their attempt at a ring. And why am I not surprised? And we all know I'm a big Shaq fan, been a big Shaq fan for years, but as always, I'm a realist. Why am I not surprised that Shaq is out for a good stretch of the regular season and won't be back until, you know, probably just in time enough to tune up for the playoffs? No big surprise there. Good job, Shaq. Way to rest it up and come strong and healthy and rested for the playoffs, as you have found a way to do many years now each season. So good job, Shaq. Way to go. Just get some rest and just come strong for the playoffs. Good job. Good job, Shaq Diesel. So that's about it, man. I'm gonna wrap it up and get my letter off here today. This week's letter is coming from Rachel, and okay, she doesn't say where she's from, but she says, "Hey Vic, I heard this week that John Krasinski was up for the role of Captain America, possibly, and you being the geek that." Wait a minute. Okay. Geek? That's a little strong, isn't it? Maybe not. Anyway, you being the geek that you are, I figured you might have an opinion on this. What do you think? Let me know. Love to hear what you have to say about it, Rachel. And again, she doesn't say where she's from, so thank you for the email, Rachel, from wherever. And I'm not that big of a geek, all right? But when it comes to these type of things, yeah. Okay, so we're talking about superhero movies. You know, I'm a big comic book guy, big sci-fi guy, and Captain America happens to be my favorite hero. You know, I read a lot of his comics coming up. And obviously, this is a huge deal for me because supposedly they're going to finally get it right this time. I think this is about the 37th Captain America movie now, on 37, 38 or something. Anyway. You know, interestingly enough, the John Krasinski thing, I remember reading that story, and the general consensus was that this was a bad idea, and I have to admit, he wouldn't have been my first pick. In fact, he was the last person on my mind. But after doubling back and thinking about it, if you saw the movie Leatherheads, which is a movie he did with George Clooney, set in, I think, the 20s or 30s, in the old football days of the 20s and 30s or something like that. He actually, number one, he's a lot bigger than I thought he was. He made George Clooney look kind of small. And then, you know, I thought that because we're so used to seeing him as Jim Halpert on The Office, this was enough of a departure where you could see a little bit of another kind of range that he has. And if you think about Cap's story, I mean, Cap comes from, you know, he's the super soldier from, the 40s or 50s or whatever. And, you know, this nerdy guy who's able to get this super soldier serum and turn into Captain America, you know, I could see where they were going with it. Again, maybe I would see somebody else in that role, but I could see where they're coming from with it. So it might not be that bad if he winds up with the role. I doubt that he will when it's all said and done. So that's how I feel on that. And before I go, I got to give out my award. And this one we're going to share because now that I think about this whole Captain America situation, my boy Kelvin, you double back, man. First, when we first heard about the story, you talked to me about, oh, you assumed that I was going to follow the general line that John Krasinski's a bad pick. You were wrong, but you just went along with it and said, yeah, I don't think it's going to work, until you found out that I thought a little bit differently. And then you doubled back and said, well, you know, I didn't want to say anything, but I do think he might not be that bad because of blah, 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 blah. Too late, partner. You say what you feel, say how you feel, and your first time out, you don't get a chance to backpedal. So you and those numbskulls that bum-rushed 880 in a so-called protest, you are this week's epic fail. And on that note, I gotta actually get out on a sadder note and bid farewell to Tom T-Bone Wolk, who was the bassist for my favorite band of all time, Hall & Oates. He passed away just recently, had a heart attack. And and also we lost another soulful cat, Teddy Pendergrass, last month. So didn't get a whole lot of noise, but we lost him. So, you know, on a soulful note, I'm going to roll out to Diane Burt, Nothing But a Miracle. This girl is sweet. She's got a sweet sound. She's got some soul, man. And, you know, we're just going to roll out to something like that. And have a good one. Peace.
Getting tired living in the living for a moment. Getting tired of hanging on the line. I wake up every morning and I pull back the curtain and wonder if it's gonna rain or shine. Getting tired of thinking. Getting so tired of begging.